Hi, I'm Serge Su, and welcome to macStudioA. If you've been following our Blueprint series, glad to see you back for part 2, creating a Mac OS X system image file. Some basic facts about the Mac OS X system image file. Firstly, a system image file contains the Mac OS X operating system, in our case Mountain Lion, plus all Mac App Store updates and third-party applications installed included on it. Secondly, it only takes minutes to restore a Mac system back to the way you originally had it, as opposed to taking hours from a clean install. And thirdly, you need two individual hard drives to create a Mac system image file, one being the Macintosh hard drive and the other an internal or external hard drive. So let's get started. What you will need: an Intel-based Mac system, plus an internal or external hard drive. In our case, we'll be using a USB 3.0 external hard drive. As always, don't forget to back up your hard drive or hard drives whenever you're using the Mac Disk Utility application. If you click on Launchpad, it will show you all the applications on your Macintosh hard drive. Everything in the yellow box will be included on the system image file. As you can see, some of the third-party applications that I've already installed will be included, as well as any updates from the Mac App Store, like GarageBand, iMovie, and iPhoto. At this point, we'll just insert our external USB hard drive and wait a moment for it to initialize. Click on Launchpad and click on the other folder, then click on the Disk Utility icon to launch it. Now from the Disk Utility taskbar, click on File and scroll and click on New. Then scroll to Disk Image from Folder. From the Select Folder to Image window, we now need to locate our Macintosh hard drive. Go to the name that you named your computer, in our case the iSurge's MacBook Air, and click on the Macintosh hard drive icon. Then click on the image button. We'll give our system image a name and scroll to the location where we want to copy it onto, which in our case is the external USB hard drive. For easy cataloging, we'll create a new folder to copy our image in. Click once on the newly created folder, then click the Save button. Now you will be asked to enter your admin details. Enter it, then click the OK button to proceed. There is no set time as to how long a system image will take to create. Ours took 45 minutes. It all depends on how many third-party applications you install on your Mac system. We'll just time-lapse it now by 10,000% instead of you waiting. Once the system image file has been created, click on the left-hand panel on the DMG file and scan the image for restore. This is quite important. If you don't do so now, it will ask you to do so when you restore it from a USB boot disk. Once again, you'll be asked to enter your admin details in order for the process to begin. Do so, then press the OK button. As before, there is no set time as to how long the scan will take. Ours took 16 minutes. Again, we'll just time-lapse it by 10,000%. Once the scanning process is complete, click the OK button. Then, double-click on your external USB hard drive and go to the newly created folder to check if your system image file is there. It will be the one with a DMG extension. Once located, right-click on it and get info. If you notice, the size is about 15.21 GB. This size usually gets bigger depending on how many third-party applications you install on it. And that concludes part 2. Hope you join us for the third and final part, part 3, putting it all together, where we'll be using what we've created in parts 1 and 2 and to demonstrate how it all works. Once again, if you have any questions or feedbacks or anything you don't understand, please leave them in the comments below. Hope you join us in part 3. Peace.